Welcome to our concert this evening. I'm John Stobie, and behind me is the Madison Community Band in its 11th season of bringing concert music to Richmond. Our first selection, Gavotna Fanfare, was premiered at a college band writers conference by Eugene Corporon at the University of Cincinnati College Conservatory of Music, Wind Symphony. It employs dissonance and sudden abrupt sounds to create an atmosphere of excitement and energy. Gritty intensity. It's a real attention getter, and maybe a fanfare to meet all fanfares. Next will be Vincent Persichetti's O Cool as the Valley. It's a musical reflection of the James Joyce poem that's found in the program. Typical of mid-20th century compositions by serious composers, the tonality or the key center is elusive, and yet there's a gentle beauty throughout the work. Persichetti began studying music at age 5, had an accomplished career culminating in service as a teacher and administrator at the Juilliard School of Music.
Thank you.
Jacob, who wrote our next election, was an admirer of Ralph Vaughan Williams. And he had intensely studied Vaughan Williams' English folk songs movement to the point of re-scoring it for orchestra. So Jacob's An Original Suite is so called because the source material is not folk songs, as it had been for Vaughan Williams. It is not an arrangement of any pre-existing material. Instead, the melodies are original, although the scoring and stylistic treatment is imitative of various other music with which he was familiar. As a multi-movement work, it's intended to be consumed as a whole. Now, I know you know that, but be ready to stop the guy next to you who's checking his Facebook or something when he tries to clap between movements.
Thank you.
So that sweet, that wouldn't take it sweet that you heard. Kind of the word, it's just not known as well as some of the other early 20th century sweets for band. And it's got a lot to offer. People should play it more. Now it was not based on folk songs, right? But our next selection is Arkansas Traveler. Was originally a fiddle tune, and Robert Sheldon has infused a great deal of energy into the tune with a delightful set, a fast, low, fast arrangement with a Cajun groove inside that propels the music.
Thank you.
is it you're phoning? Nobody knows, you know what a trombone is, you know, kid comes up in sixth grade and says, how about playing the euphonium? And the parents go, you know what? It's a little bit obscure. It's really well known in British brass bands and in concert bands in America, not typically an orchestra instrument. So think of it like this, euphonium. See, there's a Greek word called euphonos, which means good sound. For example, a euphemism, right, is a word, but it sounds better than the one we use it in place of. So a euphonium is such a pleasant sounding instrument that they named it euphonium. It all works. So some of you may have been with us a couple of years ago when James Adams soloed with the band on James Curnow's Rhapsody for Euphonium. If you heard that performance, you know what you're in for as he presents his classic showpiece for euphonium, a theme and variations on Believe Me, Follow Those Endearing Charms. The tune is actually an ancient Irish air, but the lyrics we know today, and by which we know and identify the tune, was from the Irish poet Thomas Moore, who put the Believe Me, of all those endearing charms to this older song or tune. So now you won't hear the lyrics today, just some lovely and skillful play. Please welcome the lovely and skillful Mr. James Adams.
Thank you.
And here are five of the best.